May 2019, Cardiff Met and Barlow Town competed in the Cymru Premier Playoff Final. With the scores all square at the end of extra time, the tie went to penalties. Bluebirds captain Dylan Rees, an integral part of the Met squad at the time, was under immense pressure to score from the spot.
Nedfai, lottery lawyer. A mae'r ddau dîm eisoes di profi pam. Dylan Rees i gymryd y gec nesa. Dyna sut mae sgorio cecor smotin. A ni'n mynd i ddeud oedd y ddau gyntaf di blino gormod yn ymwneud i gicio'r bel.
Met goalkeeper Will Fuller had managed to save three of the Barlow penalties before he was eventually beaten. It meant that Met midfielder Elliot Evans had the chance to put the Archers into their first ever European adventure.
I roi Met Caerdydd yn Ewrop. Elliot Evans. Keegan Jones yn cael gair bach I geisio roi Evans o ddiari echel. Elliot Evans. Tri chynnig I Gymro Meddyn Ho. Met Caerdydd sy'n mynd I Ewrop. Am I adawau, am eiliadau, i'r lluniau. Damlinellir hyn all geiriau. Faint, mae o'n I olygu.
Progress Nidacorn, the team were. They were from Luxembourg. So we had the away leg first, so we had to go out to Luxembourg. Defied, I think we played in the end, but it was a beautiful place, really hot. We lost 1-0 away. We just parked the bus and they scored late on, I think. And then we had to come out all guns blazing then in the home tie at Leckwith.
Just 90 seconds after kickoff, the Welsh side levelled the tie.
He met Elliot Evans. Sy'n ceisio creu, oh my god, he met Gendydd! Am ddechrau'r game!
A ball into the box from Dylan then resulted in a chance for him to put his own name in Cardiff Met history books.
Will Evans yn disgwyl amdani, yn codi gael gol geidwad, oedd yn ansicr. Mae'n gecwr smotin! Mae'n Davies yn disgyn! Mae'n gecwr smotin! I Met Caerdydd! Am drama! Am sefyllfa sy'n dan I fan hyn! The progress di dylcon ddim yn gallu credu'r peth. Dylan Rees yn erbyn Sebastian Flaws. Y Ffrancwr yn y gol. Rees I Met Caerdydd. Dylan Rees! Y taro! Met Caerdydd! Ar y blaen! Am eiliad! Am stori! Am olygfa! Met Caerdydd! Dwy! Progress! Nid y corn!
It was 2-0, so we were going through. And then they nicked an away goal then. But the season after, the away goals got scrapped and so we would have gone to extra time and penalties if that was the case. So, bit unfortunate, but yeah, we won in Europe, I guess. I think Progress won another game and then they played Rangers at Ibrox, Stephen Gerrard's Rangers. So
yeah,
imagine the storylines of students playing against Stephen Gerrard.
Fast forward 4 years and Cardiff Met were again looking to repeat their successes and having finished an impressive season fourth in the league. Supporters were optimistic of their chances.
See, we got there years ago. It was a great season, probably the golden generation, you'd say, of Cardiff Met. But these players have done superbly well this season and the new manager, Ryan Jenkins. So I'll be massive for the club, not just in terms of financially, but also for the players on the pitch as well.
On paper, Cardiff Met will be favourites today. Does that come with extra pressure at all?
Of course it does. You look at the way the league pans itself out and people talk about momentum. I think Haverfordwest would have the momentum with the amount of games they've won in the bottom half. However, we've played at a level, and I think the level does look after itself, playing against TNS, against Pennock, Bond, Cons Key, Balla, Newtown, week in, week out. It's difficult, so I think you've got the blend there and the mixture and the balance. But yeah, we will be our favourites, but the game's not played on paper.
You mentioned momentum, Haverfordwest unbeaten in their last seven games. What kind of challenge will they pose to you today?
They'll pose a challenge because if a bit to put the ball on the floor and be brave. When the ball's on the floor and being brave as they are, it's always tough. We've got some really good individual players. I'm a big fan of Lee Jenkins. I think he's a big, powerful centre-half that always looks at ease on the football pitch. So he'll be a threat to us all game. And they'll have other individuals that will cause us problems as well. But I'd like to think, you know, equally, we have players and individuals that will cause them problems.
Tony, Haverfordwest's first ever experience of the playoffs. How are you feeling? How are the team feeling?
Yeah, I think they're okay. Pretty relaxed, to be fair. And, we're away from home and Met are the favourites. They're a very good team. They've had an excellent season. So we've come here, you know, we've got confidence at the minute with the run we've been on, but we know it's going to be a tough test today.
Christian Edwards has just said that you guys have got the momentum going into this one. In terms of your preparations, have you changed anything this week?
No, nothing. Nothing at all. We trained three times this week, some of the lads, and just trying to do the same things, and that's what's got us to success the last few months. And you know, if it's not broken, don't fix it, and that's the way I look at things.
You're on a great run at the moment, but it's fair to say Cardiff Met, they're going to pose a pretty different challenge to what you've been used to lately.
Yeah, we lost you in December 2-0, and it was well deserved. Met were much better than us on the night, and you know, we know how tough it's going to be. We beat them at our place. It was a close game that night, but we know Met are a very good side. You know, we don't finish fourth if you're an average team. That we know the test we've got ahead of us today.
Edrych a dîm Holford wedyn ni, cryfhau lot haf diwetha. Jordan Davies di cael tymor da. Pa mor bwysig fydd e pnawn yma?
Ie, bwysig iawn. Mae fyddi sgorio 14 gol yn y gyngor eleni. Felly, fi'n credu galu ar y pêl bydd e'n bwysig iawn. Chwreu'r da iawn gyda Holford. Felly, os maen nhw'n gallu cael Jordan ar y pêl a creu cyfleuon, fi'n credu bydd Holford yn iawn.
Yn i holi ti'n gynharach, sut brofiad yw i chwarae yn erbyn Met? Sut brofiad yw i chwarae yn erbyn Holford, ddim yn gred, gysd i cedyn coch da fe, tymor yma.
Do, ie, nes i'n gofio am ti'n mae wedi bod yn...
Goffa si at goffa fe, rydych chi'n cedyn coch yn erbyn Holford.
Ie, na, tymor hir iawn. Ond, na, yn amlwg gysd i cedyn coch, ond ar y diwrnod mae Holford yn gallu meiddi unrhyw un. Maen nhw'n chwarae pêl droed yn iadol iawn.
Come on, 10 seconds of the whistle there, guys. Energy, intensity. Come on, fellas. Let's
do it again. Alright.
Come on, boys. Come on, let's go.
Cardiff, all out.
Yes. They've gone.
Come on, then.
Smash.
Yeah, my scarf out.
Tom Owen, referee, it's a big game. Having a good season, Tom, he's earned this. So, game on, Cardiff Met against Haverfordwest County to play Newtown in the final next Saturday. If Cardiff Met win, they gain home advantage for the final, having finished higher in the league than any other team in the playoffs. Beautiful afternoon in Cardiff. Let's have a beautiful game. Met kick off.
Like I said, it's been a cagey opening, what, we just shy of 20 minutes, and, you know, I think out of the two, probably Haverfordwest have settled a little bit better. I think Cardiff Met are trying to look for those channel balls, but when you've got three at the back in Borg, Jenkins and Reese, it's going to be tough for Sam Jones up there on his own.
He's been prominent. Price, will he take it early? Price takes a shot off! Great save from the goalkeeper. It was a decent shot from Tom Price. Goalkeeper did really well in keeping that out. Good strike from Price. There's the steal from Baker. Yeah, he's got done well.
He wanted it, Tom Price. He's taken it off Chris Baker, but yeah, it's a great strike.
A little bit central.
Yeah, you know, I think the quality's just starting to up a little bit from both sides now that it's settled.
Wilson, great feet from Wilson. Finds Davis. Does he take the header first time? Great header! Oh, the bar! It's a gilt-edged chance from the man on form. He has 14 goals in the league. He's the top scorer, Welshman in the league. You'd expect him to put that away.
Jack Wilson beats Craven there far too easy, but he picks out a beautiful ball here. On repeat, he has got to take it first time, and, you know, it's a really good attempt. He's just really unlucky. It hasn't just dropped into the left-hand side of Alex Lang. And
tell you what, the big man at the back there, Emlyn Lewis, and Chubb have got away with one because he's lost his marker.
Yeah, definitely. The gap's very big in between.
After a very cagey first half, Cardiff Met found themselves with a massive opportunity to take the lead with just over 20 minutes left to play.
Wanted a free kick. Sure, penalty! Ooh. What a silly way to give a penalty away. There's no doubt about it at all. And incredible to just shove somebody over in the box like that. Incredible.
As soon as Price has taken him on the edge of the box, you can see him pulling at him. And then, stupidly, in the box, bizarre.
Well, the referee won't get an easier penalty to award all season than that.
I mean,
incredible.
Thinking if you're going to do it outside the box at least, but he almost waits until he's in the box, then does it.
Henry Jones, experienced player as well. Yeah. He'll be disappointed with that. Looks like Baker's put the ball down. Or is it one of those Premier League Evans, ones? Yeah. It's Elliot Evans.
That's where his goals come from now, Elliot.
Usually the penalty king, Elliot Evans, against Zach Jones. He scored important penalties in the past.
He's been here before.
There is a plenty of pressure on this, by the way. Can Evans put the Kincoy club 1-0 ahead? Evans against Jones. Evans. What a save that is! That is a brilliant save from the goalkeeper. He's gone the right way and he's had a strong hand to keep it out. It's in the corner as well. Zach Jones, what a save.
Free. What a save. What a brilliant save. Yeah, Henry spits one over to him, gives him a little kiss on the cheek, and I don't blame him. What a great save that is.
Went the right way. Right-handed, he puts his hand in the air and had to have strength to keep that ball out because he didn't tap the penalty. Brilliant save, Zach Jones. Score remains 0-0. And Henry Jones is buying Zach Jones Christmas presents already. Chubb. Jones missed jump and ball wanted this time.
The 90 minutes finished goalless. There was to be a further 30 minutes of play for both teams to try and find a goal. Both physio Tristan Jenkins and Dr. Richard Thompson had been kept busy during the final stages of the game, so the fresh legs of Jack Leahy, Johan Evans, Ricky Watts and Yori Humphreys were soon introduced, but a resolute Bluebirds defence ensured that numerous Met attacks were all cleared.
Set plays haven't been rare this afternoon, but nobody has really spotted anybody with a good corner yet.
No one's really quite capitalised on it just yet. Again, the beauty of a set piece, you know that there's more than likely another one coming, that you've just got to try and do the right thing from the next one.
It's Price this time. Chubb on the far post, looks for him. Just collected wonderfully again by Zach Jones. What are you saying at this time now? Are you just saying, keep going for us, keep doing what you've done for us all season? You've got 15 minutes left to make the cup final.
Yeah, you've got 15 minutes left of your potential season, so this is where you've just got to give it your all. You've done, what have we done now, 105 minutes.
Javi West having that final team talk, Dylan Rees there.
There'll be some tired legs, tired minds here now in this last 15. The sun's been down all day, it's a hot day.
Duggan, Elliot Duggan has joined the fray.
Elliot Duggan's introduction as the fifth and final substitute had started to prove useful as he hassled the Met defenders for possession. But a quick transition from the home side soon tested the Bluebirds yet again.
Kapongo fires one into Sam Jones.
Great
Baker,
touch.
Can he get it?
Wow,
Jones,
what a ball.
Big chance to win it for Jones! What a save! I know the man of the match is now.
Right.
Penalty save and a brilliant save, Zach Jones. What a save
what.
That is, and what a chance for Sam Jones.
Oh, I mean, it's a great first touch. Great ball from, was it Chris Baker? Great way to pass, great first touch. Oh, it's an unbelievable save.
It's an unbelievable save, but it's an unbelievable chance to win the game for your
and
club.
That's it. It goes the other way as well.
Man of the match is confirmed. Owen Tudor Jones gives Zach Jones the Man of the Match award.
Yeah, you can't argue with that, can you?
But you still have plenty to do in this game.
Yeah.
Zach, you've got another 5 penalties to save at least. Or try to.
As the clock reached 120 minutes, the home side were awarded a free kick, with Met players queuing up with glory in their sights.
Veal's running over here.
Yeah, this is it then.
Yeah.
This is the final one. Veal, he's come on as a substitute. And this would be one of the substitutions of the decade, were he to score from here. Veal against a man who's been impossible to beat all afternoon, Zach Jones. Veal.
could have been difficult.
Ooh, he dealt with it well.
Yeah, he couldn't see with the sun.
Final whistle, and the clean sheet was kept by the MOM, Zach Jones. Cardiff Met University 0, Haverfordwest County 0.
With Cardiff Met's previous experience of winning penalty shootouts and the Bluebirds' last three shootouts ending in defeat, the away supporters couldn't have been more nervous.
Well, here we are, a penalty shootout at the Kincoyd campus to see who will play Newtown in the cup final next week to get into Europe. Kyle McCarthy, Mr. Dependable, all afternoon has stepped up to take on the main man for Haverfordwest. There's the referee chatting to the two goalkeepers about movement.
See all the fans making their way down to the other side to goal. Well,
there'll be a lot of fans down behind the goal now, Haverfordwest fans and Met. Well turned out support today, the Haverfordwest crowd. McCarthy.
Yeah, he'd be my number one probably, Kyle. Reliable, the day he's had as well.
Well, I think he'd go the way that Elliot Evans went as well.
Yeah, as a left footer.
Yeah. Kyle McCarthy against Zach Jones. First penalty in the shootout. McCarthy clips it. What a save! A brilliant save again from Jones. Just don't think he's put enough on that.
Pretty. Yeah, it's a similar area to Elliot's penalty. And again, just a big hand.
I think he saved it with his feet in the end.
With his feet?
Yeah, it looks like he saved it with his feet, Zach Jones, but he's put his team in. What a positive start. And Dylan Rees, ex-Cardiff Met player, goes to take the penalty against his old club.
Dylan again took that penalty for us in the home fixture at Leckwith when we were in Europe, so as the track record goes.
Dylan Rees against Alex Lang to give the Bluebirds a 1-0 advantage. There's the 1-0 advantage, right in the corner, gives the goalkeeper no chance, and the Bluebirds are 1-0 ahead.
Brilliant penalty, Dylan Rees has stepped up, so reliable from these. Always in training, used to go that way, and look at that side net, and you don't save those.
Great penalty from Rees. Mr. Rees to take one from the spot kick is Lewis Rees. Can somebody put the ball past this goalkeeper this afternoon? Rees against Jones. Jones again! This boy is having some afternoon. Brilliant save. Same way. Same man. Wonderful save.
Yeah, same way, same result. Look at that, yeah. Even further in the corner now. Hasn't left a leg out. Again, I don't think it's an awful penalty. I think it's a good save again. And, yeah, enjoy it.
I think Zach Jones will want this game to go on forever.
Yeah, don't let it stop.
Chance now to get the first goal of the afternoon. Jack Leahy. Second goal, sorry. Oh, brilliant. Brilliant penalty from Leahy, right in the top corner. That was a quality strike, may have hit the underside of the bar, but there was only one place that was going.
I tell you what can you say?
What I can say, Will, is that gives the Bluebirds a massive advantage. 2-0 ahead after two penalties, and there's plenty of pressure on CJ Craven on only the third penalty. Can he beat Superman between the sticks?
I tell you what, Lee could have practiced that penalty 100 times and never would have hit a better one in training.
Craven.
Big penalty here.
Against Jones. Surely not the same way. Goes the same way. Plenty of bottle there from Craven.
Yeah, he is human.
He is human. Jones says to Davis, go and do your job, son. I think this means that if they were to win, the final would be at Newtown, the team with the highest place finish. Jordan Davis to keep his team with a 2 advantage. Davis against Lang. Davis puts it in the corner. Cooley puts his hands by his ears, and it's sudden death from here onwards. Great penalty from Jones. There's times in football matches when it's your day. Henry Jones give the penalty away 20 minutes before the end of the game, and his goalkeeper bailed him out. Henry Jones now has the chance to win it for Haverfordwest County.
Yeah, I mean, it would just be written in the stars, really, for Henry to go from zero to hero, to give away a penalty and potentially win the game with a penalty kick from himself.
Henry Jones, from 12 yards, could put his team into the Europa League playoff final against Newtown next Saturday. Jones v Lang. Saved! Saved! Not positive enough on the kick. There was a stall before he took it. And Alex Lang keeps his team in it.
Why, why? There it is. There it is. When it's not your day, it's obviously not your day. What a great save.
Great save from the goalkeeper. Veal. Back of the net from Veal. Substitution paid off. And all the pressure now in the world goes on Elliot Duggan. Chance to put his team into the final. Elliot Duggan. Football's a simple game, Elliot. Put the ball in the back of the net and your team are in the final. Duggan v Lang. And his team are in the final. Duggan smashes the ball in the back of the net, and Haverfordwest County will play Newtown in the Europa Conference playoff final next Saturday.
There it is. Yeah, a brilliant penalty from Elliot Duggan. Fair play. He's just gone for power, which has, you know, obviously been the way today with a couple of missed penalties. But a brilliant penalty. You know, Haverfordwest dug deep at times, but at the end they've done really, really well to pull through, and, you know, wish them all the best.
And a goal hole for the Dathlu. Mael, gorffen yn seithfed. Allan o fynd yr holl ffordd i Ewrop?
Yeah, fi'n credu ni. Fi'n credu mae hon wedi'r ffainal heddi. Fi'n credu, os byddai Haverfordwest wedi meiddi Mercantydd fel maen nhw wedi wneud, fi'n credu mewn nhw'r holl ffordd nawr.
Beth am y gol geidwad na, Zach Jones?
Oh, wedd neb yn meiddi fe heddi. Am perfformiad gyda fe, chymod safio dau penalty, a un yn y gêm. Pob clod i fe, heddiannol iawn.
Dim goliau, ond drama a cicau o'r smotyn.
Come on! Come on! Get in! Get in! Get in!
Some of the boys have played in Europe, a lot of them haven't. I was fortunate to do it right at the end of my career, and I know how special it is, so they got one game to go. Well, listen, we know how tough it's going to be. Newtown have beat us twice this year. And another away game to go, but we'll do our best again.
Well, Zach, huge congratulations. Can you even find the words to describe that game?
I don't know what to say. I actually don't know what to say, but no, credit to the boys. We just dug in there. We fought hard. You know, it got tough, everyone cramping up, taking off, but, you know, the boys had a massive shift today. And yeah, honestly, I've got no words, honestly, I don't know what to say.
For you personally, Zach, you saved three penalties. You also made that incredible save at the end of extra time. Is that one of the best games you've ever had, do you think?
Probably. I mean, honestly, personally, I thought I wasn't playing that great.
What?
And all of a sudden, I just popped up. But no, I mean, that's our job. We're there to save goals, and no, I enjoy it.
Just give us an insight, you know, what's going through your mind when you've got a penalty, you know, to save? What's on the back of your mind?
Honestly, I don't think I've saved a penalty in about 5 years, and then all of a sudden I save three, so I really don't know. I just pick away and just go and just hope for the best, but, you know, the boys knew where the take was going in the game, so kind of just gambled there, but no, yeah, didn't really know, to be honest.
One game away from Europe, a massive cup final now against Newtown, Zach.
Yeah, no, massive. I mean, we watched it yesterday, and it's going to be tough. We know it's going to be tough. You know, they've beaten us twice. So, no, we just got to take this momentum and just go give it our best.
How much would it mean to you and to this team if you got to Europe?
Oh, massive. It means everything to this club.
I mean, you can just tell from the fans, you know, how much it means. We haven't been to Europe in I don't know how long, but no, it's huge, huge steps for this club, and that would mean everything. Yeah.
Well, you thought you didn't play very well, but you are our player of the match, so congratulations.
Thank you.
Was it a pointless 3-day bender or a weekend in paradise, my friend?
Anxious yet excited Haverfordwest County supporters had made the journey to Mid Wales for the final, but it was one couple who'd been spotted at the semi-final that had caught the eye of many long-time supporters of the club with their piece of Bluebirds history.
Myself and my stepson John were both season ticket holders at Haverfordwest at the time, so ourselves along with about 1,500 made the trip up to Ninian Park. Sadly, the result didn't go quite our way on the day, but we had a really, really good game. Lost 1-0, really, really good squad. And David Barnhouse, I think it was, gave us this shirt to my stepson, John, who can't be here today because he's moving house. And he was the captain, I think, on the day. I'm just hoping that now, sort of 20 years later, we can get into Europe again and beat Newtown today. So we watch it every week on Scorry on a Monday night, even though we live in Wiltshire now. And we saw the game was going to be on. It's a no-brainer. So trip down to Cardiff last weekend, super Zach, unbelievable effort. So yeah, fingers crossed.
Look, I think if you'd have offered me a home final in August, I obviously would have taken it, but we're up against a good team, a team coming into it in good form and momentum. Obviously, we've been there before and finished seventh, so we know the dangers that they possess, but we're looking forward to it.
We've had a great season, you know, the highest we've finished and the most goals, most wins, most points. It's hard to explain really what it means to the club and the people who've worked at the club for a long, long time. There's been loads of messages today from the lads who played in that team 20 years ago, how much they want somebody else to write the history now of the club, and that's what the boys have got an opportunity today to write their own history. And it's a tough ask coming to Newtown. You know, we lost them twice this year, but we'll give everything we've got. I know that.
With the atmosphere building at Latham Park, one member of staff was taking the opportunity of clinching a European adventure in his stride, having been a part of the coaching staff in the club's previous appearance in Europe.
Obviously qualified in 2003-2004 for the UEFA Cup. Monumental season for the club, fantastic. I was looking at some of the stats today, and that team, we played 32 games. And we'd won 17, drawn 11, lost 4. We finished up third on 62 points. But the highlight of the season really was we only scored 40 goals in 32 league games, but we only conceded 23. And I think we won about 16 games, 1-0 or 3-0.
Very similar circumstances, game that you've got to win. We've done it before. Every confidence we can do it again. And Europe, here we come.
Come on, lads. Don't be afraid. Come on. Nothing to fear here today. Nothing.
Nothing, mate.
Changing the rules.
Just enjoy it, boys. Don't get a chance to play against anything like this. So just try and enjoy it.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, come here.
Believe in yourselves and each other. Believe in you and believe in the person next to you. Come on, do the things we've good at. The things you've done all season to win games of football for us. Do those and do them excellent again, and the rest will take care of itself. Okay? Play with confidence, wait. Play with confidence. You know the way we play. No regrets. No matter what happens, you come in here after the game and we've given everything. All right, it's been a great season. Turn it into an excellent one. Come on.
Good luck, lads. With the stadium announcer fully invested in the pre-match entertainment, both teams were ready for the green light from S4C's Scorio to begin proceedings.
Good afternoon and welcome to Latham Park in Newtown, where the Robins play Haverfordwest County in the 2022-23 JD Cymru Premier Europa League playoff final. Chris Hughes' Newtown gained home advantage for the final after they defeated Ballytown, and Cardiff Met were knocked out by Haverfordwest County in a dramatic penalty shootout last weekend. It's 6th place Newtown against 7th place finishers Haverfordwest to battle out 90 minutes to play in Europe in July.
Good afternoon, Mark. Good afternoon, everybody. What an end to the season, Mark. Beautiful afternoon here for an early evening at Latham Park, and all to play for both teams.
Yeah, fantastic turnout as well. The word was that the two chairmen had got together and organised something, and so congratulations to the two chairmen, Tommy, to get such a crowd here this afternoon.
Yeah, certainly. You know, free entry for everybody has really worked well. So it's terrific to see, you know, 2,000 here this afternoon to see this game, which will see a winner at the end.
Bluebirds! 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 Bluebirds!
The tremendous away following spurred on the Bluebirds, who started the game in a very positive fashion.
Chance! First goal of the afternoon is a mistake from the fullback, but it's the top scorer. 15th goal of the season, it's Jordan Davis, giving the Bluebirds a 1-0 advantage. Davis hits the back of the net, and it's Haverfordwest 1, Newtown 0.
Yeah, dreadful error defensively by Craig Williams there. Just didn't clear it. There's been no nonsense defending from Haverfordwest every time, Mark. But this time, the ball comes across the field here. I think, for me, the keeper should have come and got back to start with. Too slow, and Williams fluffs his lines there. And Jordan Davis, like any good predator, he's on it. He's on it straight away. He reacts really well and lifts it into the net.
Yeah, it's a pretty good finish. It's one you should be finishing. But Davis, as you say, half a chance. When you're on form, you're on form. 15th goal. They have had plenty of the game so far, and if anybody was going to open a score, and it looked like Haverfordwest, and that is Jordan Davis, and he'll be proud of this, I think, Tom. That takes him definitely top of the league as Welsh goal scorers for the season. 15, and I'm sure he won't want to finish on that.
But it wasn't too long before the home side managed to create a chance of their own.
Just haven't seen anything of Craig Williams as an attacking force this afternoon, Mark.
Yeah, that's right. Stayed in the four. Rushton, as Williams, can he just put it in? Great ball in, Williams. I think you called it, Tom. You called it, Tom. And you called a Newtown equaliser. You said Williams hadn't been involved.
No.
He picks the ball up. He goes to the line, delivers, and it's the big man on the far post, Aaron Williams. It's one apiece in the playoff final.
Yeah, certainly, Williams. He got released down that right-hand side. And what a pinpoint cross to Williams at the back post.
Half-time whistle blown by the referee, Bryn Markham-Jones. It's one apiece at Leighton Park. Don't go away.
With many former players and staff in the crowd cheering on the Bluebirds, Scorio's Nicky John convinced Wayne Jones to share his thoughts.
Wayne, as a former Haverfordwest County manager, I'm just wondering, are you actually able to enjoy this first half? What have you made of proceedings so far?
Yeah, enjoying it. Obviously a bit anxious, obviously when Haverfordwest to hopefully get into Europe, but yeah, enjoying it. I think, in all honesty, up until the goal there, a bit of a sucker punch for Haverfordwest. I thought they fairly controlled the game in the majority of the first half, and a well-taken goal there at the end. But yeah, I think it's all to play for now, and you know, like you said, it's going to be end-to-end now in the second half here.
20 long years since the club were last in Europe. I know you were involved back then as well as a player. What are your memories of that time? And then also, what would it mean to the club to actually make that step forward and get back into Europe this afternoon?
Yeah, like you said, 2004, I was fortunate to be in that squad when we played out in Iceland. You know, we had a great team there. And since then, you know, the club has faltered a bit. I've been involved for the last 12 years on and off with the club. And obviously, since the new takeover the last 3 years, the new chairman's come in, you know, he's redeveloped the club from top to bottom. And that's take nothing away from David Hughes, who was the previous chairman, who kept the club afloat and obviously, you know, managed us to get to this stage. I'd like to think that we've played all a little part in building where we are now. But, you know, it's over to the big boys now. Tony, a friend of mine, you know, these are guys who are well experienced, and I think, you know, the team's developed, off the scene has developed, and they're a club that's growing strength to strength.
One thing that's fantastic, I think, as well, is seeing so many supporters here today. Both clubs deciding to allow people through the gate for free, and it's created a fantastic atmosphere, hasn't it?
It's brilliant, yeah, to be fair. Like you said, I mean, the sun shines out. You know, this crowd, it must be 2,000 plus here. You can see everyone's mixing and that, and that's what football's about. You know, we're coming to the tail end of the season now, and it's an enjoyment day, but obviously there's a lot of anxiety in both camps.
An edgy second half started with limited chances, until Henry Jones unlocked the Newtown defence, providing Jack Wilson a chance to give his team the lead.
What? Henry Jones looking for action again now. He's got the ball in. Wilson will get a chance. What a ball! Oh, what a chance! Wilson waited too long. It bounced high and he flashes it over the bar. If there's ever a chance to win a game, that has to be one of them.
What an opening for Wilson.
Wilson's normal composure being absent just showed the magnitude of what was being contested in searing heat.
Yeah, he goes. I think, to be honest, he's had too much time.
Too much time when he's gone for like a scissor volley, a special volley, instead of just passing it past the goalkeeper.
Look at Tony Pennock.
Oh, no, Pennock knows that was the chance.
Tiring legs were replaced late on in the game in the hope that it would create the chance. Jack Leahy, Johan Evans and Ricky Watts again coming on to try and find an elusive second goal.
5 added minutes. Favourites get their head on the ball first. Great corner in.
Nobody on the keeper there.
Yeah, I was just going to say, you could say it's a wasted corner, but why isn't there anybody stood on the keeper?
Yeah, exactly.
Jelly Ismail against Evans. Oh, it's a bad touch. Ismail, surely not. What a tackle. What a tackle that is. Tackle of the afternoon, gives a corner away, but when you want your team to get into Europe, you have to have people to track back 60 or 70 yards, and a Brucey does it. Brilliant tackle, son. Keep your team in the game.
He's pulling the trigger there, isn't he? And what perfect timing from a Breezy.
Shepherd. A Brucey still covering every blade of grass.
You know, I mean, you've got to deliver the ball in a box there. My
gosh. 90 minutes. It's one apiece. Newtown 1, Haverfordwest County 1.
Extra time proved much of the same, as neither team were giving the other any opportunities, and chances seemed to be only coming from long-range efforts.
Jenkins on the edge. Shane Sutton.
Wonder what's going through Tony Pennock's head there.
Yeah, well, these are the situations which, you know, we all know. You've done it. It's a real difficult period now. It's like one of them chess games where you've got one or two moves left. Otherwise, your history. And that's the manager's mind at the moment. Chris Hughes will be the same. But what you're looking for, Tom, as every football manager is one of your players to go and produce that bit of magic. It doesn't always have to be the manager who organises things.
Having suffered with a stomach illness that kept him out of action for much of the tail end of the season, Pembrokeshire-born striker Ben Fawcett was Pennock's final attacking change. The thought of a 4C winner excited those cheering on the Bluebirds, but as with much of the game, both defences were simply too stubborn.
Great tackle. Simply a great tackle. Leahy. It's Haverfordwest more than a Robins who've pressed to try and create an opening. Yep. Newtown fire the ball into the area. Goalkeeper. That's great goalkeeping. It's the 90 minutes plus extra time are over.
Just 7 days after winning in Cardiff, the Bluebirds yet again were facing the drama of a penalty shootout. After another 120 minutes of football, the relentless support was still echoing around Latham Park.
Ben Fawcett, fourth. Fifth. Cody
Sheffield. Same as last week. Yeah.
Lottery, yw hi nawr, Mac?
Lottery, ydy, a mae'n rhywun yn gorfod methu. Ben yn y Cris ar ddiwedd y Cicar Smotyn, pwy fydd hwnna? Da ni ddim yn gwybod a faint o hir fydda ni yma.
Mac, diolch yn fawr am y tro reite. Conny off.
We're back with penalties at Latham Park. The penalties have been taken at the Riverside end. Both sets of supporters trying to get behind the goals. This will be interesting. And it's Aaron Williams, the main man for Newtown up all season, stepping up to take the first penalty against last week's hero for Haverfordwest County, Zach Jones.
He hasn't been very convincing, Williams, from the spot, has
well,
he?
And he got... I don't think he would have taken many more important than this one, Tom. We said, your best first?
Yeah, absolutely.
And up he is. Aaron Williams against Zach Jones. First kick. Straight down the middle and the goalkeeper stands tall. It wasn't a great penalty. He was outwitted by the young goalkeeper who just stood there.
I think, you know, last week he missed that, didn't he? He smashed that one down the middle. Got the rebound. That's a real poor penalty from a top goal scorer.
Well, has he been outdone by watching last week's penalties where Zach Jones went to the left? Dylan Rees scored his penalty last week and he went to the right of Dave Jones here, right in the corner. Rees is Haverfordwest penalty taker. Rees against Dave Jones to take a 1-0 advantage. In the corner, Dylan Rees.
Oh.
If you're going to slot one in the corner, get it right in the corner, and that's what Rees done.
Absolutely brilliantly placed.
Almost there, Dave Jones, Tom.
Yeah. Look at that. Oh, well struck penalty by the skipper.
And it's the skipper for Newtown who stands up now to get his team back in the game. Craig Williams against the man for a penalty shootout at present, Zach Jones. Can he make it two in a row this week? Williams. What a great corner from Williams. Jack Leahy, ex-Cardiff City, put his foot through it last week to the right of the goalkeeper and almost took all the paint off the underside of the bar. You know, it was superb. Can he do it again? Leahy against Jones. Oh, quality penalty. That is a quality penalty.
Yeah, everyone's gone to the right of the keeper so far, Mark.
It's a long walk. Callum Roberts is walking the 40 or 50 yard walk up now. Callum Roberts against Zach Jones. Can he bring his team back in the game? Roberts. Great penalty from Roberts. And he'll always have a thing or two to say to the fans.
Yeah.
Jordan Davis. He scored goals all season. Scored his goal in a penalty shootout last week. Surely he would have been one of Pennock's first choices. That's what he's there for. Can Dave Jones perform a miracle and keep his team in this competition?
Bit of banter going on between the players there as well.
Yeah, it all counts. Davis. Oh, Jordan Davis puts it right in the corner. His run-up was true, his strike was true, and he puts his team ahead again.
Yeah. 3 out of 3 for the Bluebirds so far.
Henry Cowans. Zach Jones will know one save would almost secure Europe for Haverfordwest. Cowans against Zach Jones. Cowans. Oh, he's wide of the mark. Henry Cowans has gone wide of the mark of all things. You just want your player to get it on target. And does that give Ben Fawcett the chance to put his team in Europe?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, he just... Tony Pennock can't watch at the moment.
In hospital a month ago with a stomach injury. His chance to put his team into Europe this summer. Fawcett to put Haverfordwest into Europe.
Oh,
he hits it straight to the goalkeeper. Dave Jones makes a save. Big chance for Ben Fawcett. He goes to his left. Jones goes to his left again.
Yeah.
But makes the save this time.
Nice tight for the keeper as well to save that. Wasn't the best of penalties by Ben Fawcett there.
Nigel Harris has to score to keep Newtown in with a chance of going to Europe in July. Harris, Zach Jones, down the middle. Very, very cool. Very cool.
Three-all mark, and this to take Haverfordwest into Europe.
This boy strikes a ball as good as anybody, Shepherd.
But today, it's a different...
Pressure's on.
Yeah.
Pressure's on. Can Shepherd put Haverfordwest into Europe? Can Jones keep Newtown in the contest? Shepherd, it's in there! The Bluebirds are in Europe! Tony Pennock has pulled it off! A Shepherd penalty puts Haverfordwest County in the Europa League. Penalty shootout, 4-3 victory. Tommy?
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. Shepherd tucks it away. And off they go on the European adventure, Haverfordwest. And, you know, considering they finished in the bottom half of the league, they've done terrific to get to this final and win it both away games away from home.
Well, they've done the penalty shootout 2 weeks in a row. It takes a lot of guts and bottle to secure that. Zach Jones most probably goes down as one of the heroes again with the one penalty save. Pennock, gentleman of the game, is shaking hands all around.
Tony Pennock, an unbelievable afternoon, an unbelievable achievement. Haverfordwest are going back to Europe for the first time in 20 years.
Sounds good, that, doesn't it? Unbelievable. So proud of the boys, so proud of them.
It was a long 120 minutes there, and to go to penalties at the end again for the second week running. I mean, can you sum up your emotions at this point?
No, I thought, you know, we started the game same as last week, really brightly, and then we scored the goal and then went in our shell a bit. Newtown, you know, got back in the game deservedly so. As the game went on, nobody wanted to lose the game then. And listen, Zach's made a save again in penalties, and listen, I'm so chuffed for the board, the supporters. It's massive for the club.
And what about the courage that those players showed out there on the pitch this afternoon?
Yeah. Listen, they're dropping like flies again. The conditions were tough for both teams. It was so hot out there today. You know, that played a part in the game. It wasn't as high tempo as it normally is between the two of us. But listen, again, Lady Luck's on our side, so thankfully we'll take it. You know, commiseration to Newtown. They're a great football club. Really one of the best clubs in this division. I've been for a long, long time. And you know, it's our day today.
Like last week as well, did the fact that you were perhaps seen as underdogs, do you think that suited you?
Yeah. we knew it was going to be tough finishing seventh, have to go away from home against Met and today at Newtown. So we knew, there was no pressure on the boys. Listen, the chairman might have think he's a bit of, put a bit of pressure on us for obvious reasons, but the boys have been fantastic. What's that? 14 games, 10 wins, 2 draws, the last 14 games. It speaks volumes of what the lads have done since Christmas.
For the first time in 20 years, Tony, Haverfordwest are going back to Europe and you're the man that's guided them there. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Go Haverfordwest! Everywhere we go, we're singing. Hey, ho, Haverfordwest! Everywhere we go, we're singing. Hey, ho, Haverfordwest!
And scorer of that winning penalty, tell me what's going through your head at this current moment in time.
It's madness. To be honest, I was I was so nervous going up to it, but I'm just glad we got Europe now. It's a great achievement for the club.
We'll apologise for the bad language there, but obviously emotions are running high at the moment. What exactly does it mean to this group of players to be going to Europe for the first time in such a long time?
Yeah, to be honest, we've worked hard all season.
We're in Europe!
Falling off, it all showed signs of ending. You had enough for hours, but you carried on pretending. Your shoes have lost the shine, the convo's lost its pace. So now you're in a taxi, feelings of disgrace. You've never got no money because of all the time you lend. Was it a pointless 3-day bender or a weekend in paradise, my friend? The spring is in the step on Friday afternoon. There's a feeling sweeping through the air. All the lads are on the blower, they'll be finishing soon. In your mind, you're already prepared. I'll phone me man for sugar, then I'll phone our kid, cause he'll cover it till I get paid. Then you're out with all the fame and you're off your lid. Only competent, never afraid. The night goes to a close and now there's nowhere to go. You turn to look at one of your mates. There's a lad he knows somewhere, can he lives alone. So it's more sugar and a couple of cranes. But is it one of the times that it's all worthwhile and you're at the screen? Or is it bending your bridges upon this same old seat that you were 17? Oh, now the wheels are falling off, it all shows signs of ending. You've had enough for hours, but you carried on pretending. Your shoes are lost to shine, your collar lost its grace. So now you're in a taxi, feeling of disgrace. You've never got no money, cause all the time you're late.
pointless 3-day bender or a weekend in paradise, my friend.
Have it all if you like.